welcome everyone. I'm Sweets Chef Jen, and today we are going to make angel food cake. Angel food cake is one of my favorite treats. It's super light and airy with a very nice sweet vanilla flavor, and it really is a great way to showcase the perfect fruit that's coming into season, which right now is going to be nice juicy strawberries, blackberries, blueberries, raspberries. If you can get some rhubarb, some poached rhubarb is great. And then of course, when stone fruit season is in town, nice big juicy peaches are perfect with angel food cake. So right now, as you can see, I'm laying out my egg whites. As we've talked before, a scale is super important. We need 500 grams of egg whites, which is roughly 12 eggs. So what I've done is I've saved all of the yolks, which I'll use for a chocolate mousse or a lemon curd, something else like that, that is heavy yolks. And in here, I've got just my egg whites. Super important to keep all of the yolks out of the whites, because if you get any yolks in here, your whites will not whip at all. There's no saving it. Fat and egg whites do not work. So if you have butter on the inside of your bowl from a previous project, or like I said, the fat of the egg yolks, they won't whip properly. So make sure your bowl is super clean, egg whites only. Let's get started. So onto the mixer, I have my 500 grams of egg whites that I'm gonna put. Then I'm going to add two tablespoons of water. I'm gonna start this, and once it gets a little bit frothy, I'm going to add my cream of tartar and some salt.
Once your whites are frothy, stop the machine, add your cream of tartar and salt, and continue to mix at medium speed. Do not ever put the mixer on high speed.
So while my egg whites continue to whip, I'm going to add my vanilla bean to my sugar. So I want to just slice my vanilla bean in half, and then using the back side of my knife, I'm going to slide along here, put it into a strainer, slide along here, put it into the strainer. Okay, save this for a rainy day. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of sugar and push this through so that way I don't get any large bits of vanilla and I just get those really nice small pieces. Next, I wanna sift my flour with 100 grams of sugar. You want to make sure that your flour is nice and light. I use cake flour for this. If you don't have cake flour, you absolutely can use AP flour. Just make sure that you sift it so you get this nice, light flour.
Now that your egg whites are really frothing, you're going to start adding your sugar in multiple additions. Slow and steady, this process takes about 10 minutes from start to finish because you're never mixing your whites on high speed. Only medium speed. As you can see, we've added almost all of our sugar and the egg whites are almost at full volume. We've been whipping on a medium speed because it will produce smaller bubbles which create a tighter structure for your angel food cake, leaving the angel food cake to be more fluffy and light. It is well worth the long whipping time.
Okay, so we have whipped this guy to full volume. Ooh, yes. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn the mixer on low speed and we're going to slowly add our dries.
Slowly add your sifted cake flour and extra sugar. Once it is 3/4 of the way incorporated, turn off and mix the remaining in by hand.
Okay, so I've stopped this before I've added all of my flour, or before all of my flour has been incorporated, because I don't want to over whip this angel food and just let it start to deflate. So at this point, I'm just going to use a nice rubber spatula, and I'm going to fold the remaining parts of the flour into this angel food cake. Again, you want to make sure you get all the way down to the bottom, so that way you don't have any bits of flour clumped at the bottom. Keep folding until all of your flour has been incorporated. And what's good is that we have already sifted our flour, so that way it should be really nice and light. if you've ever made angel food cake before and it's ever collapsed on you, the reason it's collapsed is because you've probably sprayed the pan or there's fat on the pan. You want to make sure that your pan is nice and clean. So I gave this an extra scrub and dry before I used it because the egg whites need something to grab onto. The cake needs something to hold onto, otherwise it will just collapse. So now I'm going to add my cake into my pan. Look at how beautiful that is. So light and fluffy. What I really love is the fact that you can see all these bits of vanilla bean. Normally I would say you can use vanilla extract. And if you have vanilla extract, you absolutely can. However, if I'm gonna splurge on vanilla beans in something, I splurge for an angel food cake. Because there are so few ingredients to an angel food cake as is, you really want that lovely vanilla flavor to come through. Plus, you see all these beautiful little bean bits in there. Oh, it's so beautiful. Okay, 350 degrees into the oven we go.
The angel food has been baking at 350 degrees in a convection oven for about 30 minutes. If you touch it and it springs back, it's finished. If not, it may need to go a few more minutes. Then, carefully flip the pan upside down onto a cooling rack and allow the cake to cool upside down completely.
So I've let the angel food cake rest for about 20 minutes upside down. The whole idea is that, again, if you flipped it this way, a lot of times your cake will start to sink in towards the center. So what I'm going to do is just let it rest 20 minutes. It's halfway cool. So now I'm going to use, if you have a small offset spatula or if you have more of a dull knife, you can just slide it around the sides to loosen the cake, and then we'll pop this cake out. The reason I don't like to use a sharp knife is because I don't want to cut into the edge. I want to keep it really nice. And then what I'm going to use is just kind of gently use my hands, bring it off the bottom. And again, if you need to slide something around, that's fine. I'm actually using just like a knife for cheese, like a small spreader, because I didn't have an offset. And I just don't want to cut into the cake. A little wiggle. Is gorgeous. It has really nice spring back. It is going to be delicious. So I'm going to continue to let it cool on this rack before we decorate it. So our angel food is totally cold. Now it's time for the fun part, decorating. I'm going to take it off and I have this little cardboard cake board that I'm going to put this on. If you have a beautiful cake plate, that also works, or just a really fun decorative large is nice, so that way you don't have to transfer it around once it's time to serve it. And then I've got some whipped cream. I'm going to put the whipped cream right into the center because the more cream the merrier. And then so I've just done a little bit of whipped cream with some vanilla beans and a little bit of powdered sugar. I always use powdered sugar when I'm making whipped cream versus regular granulated sugar, just because I feel like it dissolves and gives a nicer texture to the whipped cream. Here we go. And if you have a piping bag, cool, you could make a really beautiful design on top with your whipped cream. And the magic of this cake is that it's really like you want it to look light and airy and like dreamy like a cloud. And so I don't really think it needs to have so much form to it, just kind of loose with the beautiful cream, light and airy. That looks great. And then I have some strawberries that I'm gonna start by putting on here. Oh, I love, love, love this cake. And again, it's super easy to make. It's so delicious. And you can use it year-round, but really, as soon as you get really nice berries and stone fruit, that's when I'm like totally obsessed with this cake. I've got some blackberries I've cut in half that I'm gonna put in here. If you were gonna serve this immediately, I would say it's nice to also toss your berries in a little bit of granulated sugar, because what that will do is it'll make all of the berries kind of glisten and the juice will start to kind of come out of it a little bit. But if you're not gonna serve it for a couple of hours, and I wouldn't do that, that's what's happening with this cake, because if you, it will start to sog out too much. You don't want the juice to be leaking all over the berry, all over the cake and all of that. So again, if you're gonna serve it right away, definitely toss your berries in a little bit of granulated sugar. It's really a nice touch. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put some fresh raspberries on here. These look great. And then for us, I really try to utilize what I have around. If you have a small garden, or you have even some pots on a porch, you can grow some mint, and that's a really fun decorative way to up your cake decorating game. The other thing that you can do that I really love is pansies or violas. Those are both edible, and those look super fantastic on a cake and super bright and colorful. So if you had a pot at home that you've got some space to garden, throw some mint or some pansies, violas, anything that's edible, barrage tops, in that pot, and I promise you, you will definitely love how it looks on a cake later. And then, because anybody who's worked with me in the past knows, I love gold leaf. And there's no reason for this cake to have gold leaf on it, other than the fact that I have it and I love it and I like to add a little bit of flair whenever I can. So I'm just gonna put a little couple of pieces on this cake to really punch it up. Again, I fully do not expect anyone at home to be putting gold leaf on their angel food cake, but for me, it's just fun right now. This is gorgeous. So here we are. We have this beautiful angel food cake. I'm gonna post the recipe in the last slide. I hope y'all try it. This easily can serve, if you're doing a 10-inch cake, I would say you could even, if you're cutting it very conservatively, you could get 16 nice portions out of this. If you wanna really go all out, it easily serves 12 to 16 people. So hope you're having a wonderful weekend. Tell me what you're baking, and I'll see you next time.